Let's cut to the chase. Max SPL is the abbreviation for maximum sound pressure level. So, what is max SPL? It is a maximum sound pressure level the mic can process without distorting the original sound. So, max SPL is the threshold at which microphone's output signal starts getting distorted. The louder the sound, the higher the pressure. Therefore, max SPL is the maximum loudness of the sound source. Just to emphasize that, max SPL is not a threshold at which your microphone would get damaged. The most common cause of a distortion is the overloading of the microphone's electronic circuitry. In other words, the electronics inside the microphone determines its max SPL and not the mic's diaphragm or capsule. Electronic circuitry of condenser and active ribbon mics get overloaded more easily and hence are more susceptible to sound pressure than dynamic and passive ribbon microphones. But what do we mean by distortion and how is it measured? Distortion means the output signal doesn't fully represent the input signal due to the overloading of the electronic circuitry. The max SPL is measured by calculating the total harmonic distortion. THD is a percentage of distortion present in the output signal. By increasing the SPL, the THD increases. Once the THD reaches 1%, then it is classified as a max SPL. 1% THD is used as a threshold because human ear cannot detect any distortions below 1% THD. THD is measured by applying a sine wave as an input voltage to the electronic circuitry of mic and then measuring a number of harmonic voltages. Therefore, THD is the ratio of root mean square of number of measurements of harmonic voltage divided by the voltage of the fundamental component. The fundamental component is the pure sine wave. It is difficult to compare the max SPL of one microphone with another without knowing the test signal frequency range, level and gain conditions, and number of measurements taken. Voltage is applied directly to the circuitry rather than sound pressure because it is impractical and inconsistent to reproduce such a high loudness. Therefore, the applied voltage is then converted into the theoretical SPL by using the microphone's sensitivity. It means that the diaphragm or capsule of the microphone are not tested for distortion as they are unlikely causes of distortion. If you are just recording your voice, then max SPL is not as important. However, if you want to record a tambourine or a drum, then having a higher max SPL would ensure that you could record without any distortions. Some examples of high max SPL are up to 130 decibel SPL for a mic at a half a meter of a trumpet, up to 135 decibel SPL for a mic at an inch from the loudest human voice, and up to 145 decibel SPL for a mic inside a kick drum. I cannot finish this video without mentioning that loud sounds can be very harmful to your ears. World Health Organization recommending maintaining environmental noises below 70 decibels over 24 hours. CDC provides good guidance on the level of loudness of various sound sources. It is helpful to use these values and compare them against the microphone's max SPL and see whether your microphone is able to handle your desired loud sound sources. If you're not intended to record high loudness sounds, then you don't need to be worried about the max SPL. Did you know if the sound pressure levels exceed 194 decibel SPL, it creates a vacuum and hence no air molecules to form the negative parts of the sound wave. So 194 decibel SPL is the physical limitation of the sound itself. I hope this video helped you to better understand the max SPL. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments below. To learn more about microphones, please don't forget to watch my other videos in here. And as always, to support my channel, please don't forget to subscribe.